when Joe Biden was vice president in 2014. Perhaps it was not a coincidence, as it was quickly seen Ukraine was overthrown, more or less. This new government was very closely aligned with the U.S., and the VP was sent over there many, many times. Just to put it in a little context, that was the climb. He was working very closely with the Ukrainian state, which is all very related to this congressional debate when Joe Biden was VP. Hanging out in Ukraine, perhaps there is someone who could help to explain why when his son Hunter was kicked out of the Navy, how he wasn't riding a train made of gravy, when suddenly the young man had a corporate job. I guess that could have happened to any other Georgetown slob. Consulting with Kiev, making millions of dollars, but it looks a lot like a leash and collar. Looks like C-O-R-R-U-P-T-I-O-N. This is the ballad of Delaware Joe and Kiev's Hunter Biden. Now it's only circumstantial evidence, but it's increasingly hard to sit on this fence. It could be that there isn't any smoking gun, but when the U.S. vice president's son makes twice as much money as his father was paid, it sure sounds like Hunter would have made the grade to lobby for a foreign power. If his last name was Trump, he could have worked in Trump Tower. Looks like C-O-R-R-U-P-T-I-O-N. This is the ballad of Delaware Joe and Kiev's Hunter Biden. Where the pieces fall now is anybody's guess. The Senate will have their hearings here in the U.S. War, peace, impeachment, who knows what comes next? But if the pattern holds, we all know what to expect. A state controlled by money, whether domestic or overseas. A nation ruled by nepotism, by family dynasties. Politicians acting just as you'd expect puppets to do. Sold to the highest bidder, whether purple, red, or blue. C-O-R-R-U-P-T-I-O-N. This is the ballad of Delaware Joe and Kiev's Hunter Biden. C-O-R-R-U-P-T-I-O-N. This is the ballad of Delaware Joe and Kiev's Hunter Biden.